mixed media art, collage, decoupage, washi tape, alcohol inks, this other pearl paint, all kinds of stuff, whoops, to make crazy pages. If you are art inclined, love art journaling, mixed media, and crazy stuff, this is your channel. In this video, I'm going to be decoupaging some napkins, some tissue paper, maybe some of my cleaning napkins, not just the pretty printed ones. And I will be using as well some alcohol inks, just willy-nilly. I have also some gorgeous washi tape. I am not exactly sure, I don't have a map to know where I'm going. All I know is that I'm going to make all of this with Mod Podge, but the matte medium can be used as well, and I will be adding all of this on my vellum paper, which is a 14 by 17, and then whatever I create with this, I will cut it in 8 parts for sending to 8 wonderful artists that are participating with me in this Crazy Pages activity by snail mail that I organize for a little group. If you would like to participate in one of the things that I am organizing, click in one of the groups that I have below. Some are for mail activities to ship all over the world. Some are for painting. And I also have the 29 Faces group, which is sort of active all through the year, but really crazy going on September and February. So the next September, make sure that you're in there so you can make all kinds of faces with anything that you have at home. For this particular Crazy Pages video, I have these gorgeous colors that are from Color Art, and this is Baboon Red, which looks kind of like a deep grape purplish red. This beautiful turquoise, which is called Guatemalan Green. This beautiful, oh my gosh, all the colors are so gorgeous. Stargazer, Snapdragon, Emperor's Gold, and Autumn Leaf. So I don't know if I'm going to use them all or only one, I don't know. And the colors of the alcohol inks that I have handy are, well, some green, oh, it has a name here, lettuce, eggplant, cranberry, and butterscotch. I have more, but let me see, stream and wild plum. Okay, I'm going to try to coordinate all the colors because I don't want anything too clashy, but it can clash, I'm okay with that. For the washi tape, I have this little box, I have some other ones, but I think I'm just going to stick with this. And like always, I might use one, I might use all of them. I don't really know until I am putting it on the paper. It's been a long while that I don't use a Mod Podge, but it's a really good thing. And my other, well, I don't even know where it is right now, but the other thing that you could use if you want to follow along is the matte medium, which is one of the best things created by man, I think. I am going to, I'm going to put this back. I'm going to go with this purplish and the gold. Maybe some blue. And this plum. And the green, probably. And like I said, I might bring them all back. I don't know. I have a little card to just spread the Mod Podge. And I also have somewhere around here my brush. Well, somewhere around here I have a brush. I will be cutting this beautiful napkin, which is kind of like a wine red, and some flowers, white with the backwards colors. This is the yellow on the red, and this is the reddish on the white, which I have torn one already. In the beginning I thought I was just going to use the white so it can kind of get lost in the background, but then I thought, nah, I'm going to be just putting the colors all over, so it won't matter if I have a red and then a white. And to separate these things, usually you take a bit of a time. Lindsay, the frugal crafter, suggested to use some tape to separate them. To separate them, you can use like rubbing them, or like Lindsay, the frugal crafter, recommended to use some tape. I just don't know if I have tape close by, so give me a second. Okay, I'm going to use one tiny piece of tape on one side and another one on the other side and kind of pull. I either tear it or open it, I don't know. Okay, here we go. It's a slow process. And sometimes you don't have to do it, depending on the napkin. Sometimes the napkins are like extremely tight glued together, the layers. In that case, you don't really need to get rid of the other layer, but you might end up with some wrinkles or bubbles, which is extremely annoying. So I am going to be doing this gently to a few of the napkins, and then I'm going to be going around each flower like this. So you get the point. I'm just going to trim them a little closer to the actual shape of the flower, and I'm going to just place them all over the place. Same with this beautiful tissue. I'm just going to select some torn parts and just add them to different areas of my vellum. I'm going to speed that part of the video until I have the surface ready to start going around with some extra color. I'm going to be putting some tape behind my vellum so it doesn't wiggle too much on me. So I can start going with the brush and with the other card that seems to be missing now. Here. And so I can just spread the Mod Podge without this going all over the place. And let's start. If it tears and if it wrinkles, I do not care. The whole point is to make a lot of texture, so don't let that stop you. Bubbles are a different matter. If you get bubbles, you later on can cut the paper and you can cut the paper and then you can pinch the air out. There's another way to make sure that you have no bubbles, which is put your material and then put a plastic, like a plastic bag or a kitchen plastic, and flatten it on top of your work. But I don't want to do that right now because not only I don't have it handy, I also don't have all the room for dealing with the plastic. And I don't think there is a worse fate than having decoupage, mud podge, and sticky, goopy stuff on your carpet, right? Well, I'm not going to be using the card because this tissue is so thin, you don't really want to destroy it all with the hard plastic. However, if we were dealing with scrapbook paper, then you can easily be smoothing it with your plastic card. I'm going to add a little bit of mud podge in my corners as well, even if it doesn't have any napkin or tissue, so that gets a little bit reinforced. And I'm going to let it dry. I'm making sure that I don't leave too thick a layer of the mud podge anywhere so it dries faster and also kind of evenly. And I'm going to let it dry for a bunch of hours until it is completely dry. So I will be seeing you in a few minutes. This is next day and the vellum paper is completely dry. I found these other ingredients to add to this crazy recipe, and it is the Reeves water-soluble crayons and burnt sienna, violet, and black. I might use some other ones, maybe a little bit of this yellow. I'm not quite sure. I just grab the things as I see them, and now I'm going to be just going with my brush in random splotches to cover the white areas and fill this with all kinds of wild colors. I should have brought more water, but let's see if what I have here is enough. Okay, I'm going to fast forward this. Thank you. Now I think I'm going to use this distress stain. It is a green. And I like to make it like big splashes of color. I think I'm going to add this other, what is this? It's the Guatemalan green. So I am going to add this green in little places. If I notice once it's dry that it needs some resting areas with the white, I will come back with some white color and make some other little areas for the eye to travel. So pretty much I'm just playing, waiting for the sign to tell me what direction to take. For now, what I want to do is waiting for it to dry, and then I will come back with some other something, maybe washi tape, maybe just some little white areas, but I have to wait for it to dry so I don't make a muddy pool of stuff, okay? Everything is back to dry, and I have to say this type of paint is very thick and with a very long time to dry, and it also brings you a lot of 3D texture, so it is something that has to be considered. It took me longer than expected, but it's dry, except for the distress stain. Somehow, although I have worked with it in the past and didn't give me a problem, right now on top of this combination of paints, it took extra long to dry, and I had to actually take some of the excess, although I wanted it like really thick paint when I splashed it, but I had to take some of it with a napkin because it still was staining. It's dry, but I feel that it's going to be moving again a little bit. So what I'm going to do is I want to bring back the flowers, but in an orange. I think that's what this needs, to pop the flowers back up again. Maybe a little bit of some pink and some white marker to make the flowers pop more. And I will be using a smaller brush. Maybe if I find, no, this will be fine. Usually I like to use my messed up ones like this because it gives you more of a random brush mark. Maybe this, but I just don't want it too small because I want the petals kind of big. So I will be just going on top of what is already there, and let's see what happens. Thank you. this is next day, and I will be adding a little bit of black lines with the skinny side of a Sharpie, just in the leaves, so they have more of a presence. And then I will see if I also want them in other areas. And I'm going totally outline, out of key, it doesn't matter. It actually looks prettier if it is not exactly where it should be. And this flower needs to pop a little bit more. Although in the camera, things tend to look different. In person, it looks a little bit like it needs a little extra help. I want to make some areas a bit more lighter, so I will be adding this, maybe this. No, I don't want more flowers. This is the lightest, I think. Yeah, it's the lightest washi tape I have. It has numbers and a really pretty design. So I will be adding just little bits here and there. I have been fighting this nasty cold. It's so annoying. And I start to feel better and then I start to feel worse. So I will be just putting them in here. No reason behind the position of these things. And most likely they will be in places where the paper is going to get caught. So part of this is going to be in one side, part of it is going to be in another. Also, it will need a coating of matte medium or varnish or something. And I also, I am planning to do something to the back, so it's not just blank. But I will be doing that in, I'm sorry. I will be doing that just in a quick speed version, because as it is, this video has taken a long time. And let me know in the comments if you like longer videos or shorter videos. I am always interested because sometimes people only want to see a quick thing. I'm going to add the medium and I will turn the paper and do something to it. All the medium is dry, and let's take a closer look. If you're new to this channel, click on the red button to subscribe and select the bell so you will be getting notifications every time I upload a video. And also, do not forget to go and check my friends that are participating on this Crazy Pages collaboration. All the links are at the end of this video. Visit every channel. Click like, leave a comment. We all feel really happy when we hear from you. And if you like this video, feel free to share it. So now I am going to turn the paper the other side. This was my tape that was helping me hold it back. And I will apply a very little layer of very thin, bright layer of something, probably, well, I'm going to think about it. I want something that will match with this, So between the purples, golds, and orange, maybe a little bit of aqua. I will just do a little wash, but I will pick my colors and come back.